Hi, my name is Anwar. I'm a designer, a developer, and a teacher at Treehouse. My pronouns are he, him. In this course, we're going to learn techniques for better control over our CSS layouts. We'll cover how the CSS box model impacts the presentation of each HTML element, learn to control the position of each element on screen, and even begin to adjust our layouts for different screen sizes and environments. To get the most out of this course, you should have at least a decent grasp of the basics of working with CSS. If you don't, I recommend checking out our CSS Basics course, linked in the teacher's notes, before you rejoin me right here. Gaining more control over your CSS layouts starts with one very important concept: understanding the CSS box model. The box model is what describes the amount of space each element takes up on the page. Although it may not seem obvious when viewing a web page, every element in HTML can be considered a rectangular box. Say your page contains a heading using the H1 element. That's a rectangular box. The paragraph of text beneath it, that's a rectangular box. And if those two elements are wrapped inside a div, well, that means your two smaller boxes are inside one larger box. Calculating the size of each of these boxes requires more than just measuring the width and height of the content. The box in the box model is actually made up of four distinct parts that calculate its size. Let's examine our paragraph. The innermost area and core component of the box is the content area. In the case of our paragraph, this is determined by the amount of text we have. Surrounding that content area is the padding area. Padding is often used to give the content area some breathing room by separating the content from the surrounding border area. The border area of the box is the outermost part of the box. You can think of it as giving the rectangular box an outline. Borders tend to be hidden on most CSS elements by default. But once visible, different styles like color and thickness can be applied to them. Finally, the margin area exists outside of the box. It's the space around an element that separates it from other elements. It's pretty easy for beginners to mix up padding and margin, so if you're a note taker, you might want to write this down. Padding creates space inside the box. It's the space between the content and the border. Margin creates space outside the box. It's the space around the border. As you'll see throughout this stage, padding, borders, and margins are important components of the CSS box model. They are the properties that wrap the content area of a box. Now that we've covered the main properties of the CSS box model, we're ready to put these concepts to work. That's coming up next.